I am clenching. If I decide to do something else or nothing, I feel I will be less useful to mission. Due to progressive decline in contacts, out of sight, out of mind, this is my concern. Please comment. Next question. My mission is to make you unclutch. Nothing else. Let it be very clear. I am not a missionary. I am not a missionary to do anything else. My mission is to make you unclutch. One more important thing. By unclutching, if you don't support the mission, you should not support. See, let me be very clear. Many people involve themselves into my mission for various reasons. For various reasons. If you unclutch, because of that, if your involvement is less, or you being productive to mission is less, never bother about that. That's good for you and good for me. Good for the whole mission. Good for everybody. It will be good for everybody. If you are being productive to the mission is due to the enlightenment experience which you had, satori which you had from this unclenching truth, that will be the right help. That will be the right service. So I feel, if you completely imbibe the truth which I am teaching, that will be the greatest service for the mission. Is it possible to be still doing what I am doing and still live an extraordinary life in an ordinary way? One thing, I cannot assure it will be possible for you to be doing what you are doing after February 7th. That I can't assure. I can assure that in NSP, ASP and DSP and all those things, somebody has written a letter. Self, ego, mind are put together with a shaft created from thoughts. Thoughts are independent, unconnected, random and illogical. Ahankara versus mamakara conflict causes the problem. All of these you have covered with LVP and NSP. What is new? Writing down the thoughts also we did in NSP. What is new? I'll tell you before the February 6th. Whoever has put this question, guarantee this fellow will not be same again. You fellow, you will not go back and do your routine. Live your life. You put the question? Khan. Doctor? You see, in NSP or ASP you heard. Now you will see what happens. Now, actually I had my eye on him already. Now, without even knowing that he, I already blessed. Now nothing can be done. Now it is between you and me. Whether I am successful or you are successful, let us see. See, knowing these words is totally different. And you being boiled, you will see it. Actually, that's why I am telling you, all the programs which I did is more a... It's not spirituality. See, there I tell all these words, but what for? Just to create a little bit of health or feel good feeling in you. Not to take you to the depth, you understand? I never took you to the depth of those words. It was all these things were told and you had little consolation. Again you are asked to run. You are put in the same thing. But now I am not talking all these things for that purpose. What word I utter is not important. For what it is being uttered. There the purpose itself was totally different. Just to fix you into the society those words were uttered. Now, these words are uttered not to fix you into the society, to give you the truth behind these words. Even prior to knowing you, I always felt and voiced that all our possessions, house, property, social status and professional license can be taken away any time if one is not careful and exercise discrimination. I always said when somebody praised our house that we are only trustees of the trust, residing temporarily. You know, in America, bank owns the house. Bank owns the house, even if house is paid off. Failure to pay property tax will result in eviction. If this thinking, unclutched state or not, understand, it is only clutched state. Because you are clutched to the house only, you are thinking so much about paying the tax and paying off. The unclutched man, I do not know whether he will pay or not, but he will not think about it. That much I know. Whether he will pay or not, that I don't know. That we will see after February 6th. But he will not bother about all these things. That much only I know. This question is not a challenge, just a doubt. The ego and mind are the shaft created using thoughts. So there is no me and no you. Nityananda, yes, that is true. Then nobody is there to be enlightened and nobody to enlighten. That's also true, no doubt about it. But this body and mind does not experience the bliss you describe. Why? That is where I am needed. Understand? The first three statements which you made are only assumptions, not experienced by you. Now you will have to work on it. Now you will have to grind that. Once it is sent inside, one more thing. Let us analyze it even in the other way. Who is the person who says that bliss is not experienced? When there is no you, no me, then who is there who is telling the bliss is not experienced? Then there is you. Am I right? Then you can't say the word. There is no you, there is no me. There is you. Only there is no me. Understand? There is no Nityananda, but there is a doctor. Okay? He is only writing, na? The bliss is not experienced. It means, no, I found out by the handwriting. There is no Nityananda, but there is doctor. So naturally, when you say that this body and mind does not experience the bliss you describe, I never feel that this body and mind belongs to me. That's why I'm blissful. The moment you say this body, mind, means you are there. So naturally, you can't say there is no me, there is no you. You can only say there is no Nityananda, but there is a doctor. Now we'll work on it. We'll work on all these funny things. One thing, understand. Now you know the basic truth. You are unclutched, illogical, independent, irresponsible, unconnected, unclutched. Now just sit and see whatever is happening. When you are unclutched, why should you respond to any thought? Tell me. Why should you respond to any thought? Why should your mind, why should your body follow any thought? There is no need. You are unclutched by your very nature. Am I right? You are unclutched by your very nature. You all understood. Now it is time just to experience. You all know you are unclutched, unconnected, illogical, independent, irresponsible, and totally unclenched. Once more I am repeating. Unconnected, illogical, independent, irresponsible, and unclenched. These are the thoughts. This is the things which are, this is the thing which is happening in you. Now what are you supposed to do then? Is there anything to be done? No. Just be unclenched. Just be unclenched.
Our thoughts are useless. Huh? Our thoughts useless.
Thoughts?
Are the thoughts useless?
Are the thoughts useless? What use you found from thoughts?
99% thoughts are totally useless. So.
That's all. You yourself realize it. Yes.
So, what is it within us is telling us that it is useless?
What is this?
I mean, there has to be some faculty within us that is telling us this is illogical, this is unconnected. So again, the mind is the
one. So you say there is a faculty.
The mind is the one that has to decide whether it's illogical or logical, isn't it? So again, we are using the
Okay, see, mind is the one which is supposed to decide whether it is logical or illogical.
Correct.
That's the truth. So what is that mind?
Bundle of thoughts.
Bundle of thoughts. That's what now you saw.
Right.
Now what is the bundle of thoughts?
But again, in order for you to know it is illogical, you need to have something to tell you that's illogical.
What is it that you should ask yourself? See, you are asking from what scale you can tell whether it is illogical or not. I tell you, you can't even call this such actually illogical because you don't have any other word, you are using it as illogical. It can't even be described as illogical. It is logically illogical or illogically logical. You can't even describe, it is illogical. As doctor told, it's right. You can't describe, it is illogical. If it is illogical, then what is logical? We don't have any word, that's all. Because of that, we are using the word illogical. Now only one by one, everything is coming out. You are God, I am God. Who said I am God and you are God? Who told you this? I told you. Long before. Now completely it is unclenched. How can you say that Nityananda only is sitting in front of you now? Let's have a little fun. God is everywhere. Why go to Kumbhamela? Who went to Kumbhamela? And why Anandeshwar temple? Who said there is a temple? I don't know. Who put this question? But I understand. You are God and I am God is a word. Now which you need to digest. Just be unclenched. You are God and I am God will become experienced to you. See. Now let us analyze. You say, I am God. And you are God. Next moment itself, you are suspecting it. That is why you are putting the question, why Kumbh Mela? So this means your thoughts are not consistent. Am I right? You say, I am God and you are God. If you keep quiet, then okay. But the next you put the question, then why go to Kumbh Mela? It means your thoughts are not logical. Am I right? They are not logical. First you are telling one and the second you are telling something else. It means your thoughts are unconnected, illogical, independent, irresponsible, unclutched. Just realize that. And the third word, why Anandeshwar temple? Now you are bringing the God also. The fight is after all between you and me. Why are you calling the poor guy? He is somewhere sitting happily. First thing, the logic with which you are asking the question has no base. Has no base. First, look into yourself and see how you are. Then ask any other question. This very question shows you are independent, unconnected, irresponsible, illogical, unclutched being. Thoughts are so illogical. Then which thoughts do we pick up? Is it based on our samskaras? What happens after enlightenment? You don't need to pick up any thought. Why do you need to pick up any thought? You don't need to pick up any thought. Is it based on our samskaras? Where is samskara? Samskara is also one more thought. One thing I'm so happy that I wanted that a certain level of confusion should be created. By seeing the question, I am very clear that that is created. Now we can go deep. Now we can dig the whole thing. What happens after enlightenment? Why do you bother about that? Never self. You are asking, no random thoughts at all. Let me be very clear, no thoughts at all. Forget about random thoughts. You are sitting in front of a person who is speaking without thoughts. Who is speaking without thinking. That is why I am able to speak for so many hours without preparing. If you are preparing and talking, if you already prepared the lecture and bringing it and you are delivering it, two things, you need time to prepare the talk, and the second thing, and then after delivering you repent that you missed so many points. One more thing, there are some intelligent guys, they don't need to prepare outside, but during the talk itself, they will mentally prepare and start talking. Even if you do that, you will become tired after talking 1 or 2 hours. You can't be talking hours after hours. One more thing, person who mentally prepares and talks will be bored of talking the same subject second time. If you are a teacher, you know. If you are a teacher, you know. But I am talking almost the same thing for last 4 years, 4.5 years now. Now, in 5,000 hours DVD, practically I am getting the same thing. Because I am not thinking and talking. When we think logically, are we not connecting thoughts? What you think as logic itself is illogical. You connecting thoughts is not actually connection. What you think as connection, you bring the nearer possible, the nearer concept thoughts. It's like a let me describe. Ajata Veda, there are 2 kinds of Vedas in the Veda means differences. Ajata Veda and Swagata Veda. Swagata Veda means by the quality itself, it is 2 different things. The difference between cow and the monkey. By the very birth, they are 2 different. There's one more Veda. The difference between your hand and your head. It's by quality, it's the same body, but inside the body, the like a subdivision.
This is Ajatavada means by birth, by jati, they are not too different. The earlier division is totally different between cow and donkey, cow and monkey. By nature, they are two separate things. The second kind of Veda is, by nature, they are not two separate, same body, but two different parts. But there is a difference between your hand and head. Your hand's job is different and head's job is different. So, when you think logically, you may not connect the thoughts with Swagata Veda, but even then your thoughts are not Ajata Veda. You understand? There's a minor division. Even what you think as logic is not completely connected. Between every thought there is a difference. There is a quantum jump. You may not observe it clearly. You may not understand it. If you look even with whatever you think as logic, just see when it goes on inside. It won't be logical. It will only jump in. Your logic is also not enough logical. What you think as logic, see, for example, let's analyze this one logic, Nyaya. There's a two kind of Nyaya, logic. In Nyaya Sutra means about logic in India, there's a big darshana, means a big tradition which teaches the logic. There's a two kind of logic. One kind of a logic is like if you read the two statements, you can come to the conclusion of third statement. For example, all men have got one head. Socrates is a man. Now you know the third statement. What is the third statement? Socrates has got one head. This is one kind of logic. There's another kind of logic. Here, this gate has got two doors. First statement. Second statement, one door is open. You can't say the other door is closed. But now, before I uttered this word, your mind has come to the conclusion? Is it not? The moment I utter the word, there is a two door. One door is closed. What your mind says? How can you say that? So this is the life logic. Life's logic is not logical. It's not logical. Many times, you see, you think by connecting, and making everything by generalizing. But when you live in a very small, narrow way. Your thinking happens in a different play. Your living happens in a different play. That is why so much of suffering. For example, if you hear the news, your friend is loving somebody. Immediately you come to the conclusion, you are not being loved. But the quality of love is such that you love more number of people, you are more open. You pour yourself so much. You know how to shower yourself. But your logic does not agree with that. Life, the big problem with the life and logic is, in reality, nothing is logical. But in thinking, you are trying your best to connect everything and put everything into one logic. So that you can manipulate it. Whatever is logical, you can manipulate. You can manage. But fortunately, life is not logical. Whatever you try to do, it is not possible. could not unclutch last night. Are I am not able to unclutch is also one more independent, illogical, irresponsible thought. Why are you bothered about it? Let it come. Unclutch from that, over. Where you already working on this. I observe the inward and outer me, and that those are unclutched. And there is duality I have been trying to identify. But I have not felt this change in perception. What holds me back? Nothing holds you back except your idea that you are not able to perceive. Now you say you are having an idea you are not able to perceive. Just unclutch from that thought, over. Just unclutch from it. Who is saying you are not enlightened? You. Just unclutch from that thought, over. Why are you clutching with it? That's all. I don't know what I want, or where to live, or what to do. That's nice. That's the way to live. Are you only if you are living? Person who doesn't know where to live, what he wants, what to do, he is the only person who is living his life. Everybody else is doing, living their desires. Their desires are living through them. If you have a desire to live in this ashram, that desire is expressing itself, fulfilling itself using your body. You are being cheated. Understand? If you have a desire to live here, that desire is now fulfilling itself by using your body. That is the truth. You are not living. Your desire is living. If you don't know what to do, if you don't know what you want, you are living. Why are you bothered about it? You are the right person to live on the planet Earth. I prayed and you have all the answers to each specific prayer. Yet I fear I am missing something still. If I can't find a way to make the quantum leap now, the easiest way I have ever heard of, does that mean it won't happen? Can you give me the maturity I need? Now I am giving, take it. Now just now I told you already that you are the right person. So forget about wanting to do something, wanting to live in somewhere, wanting to do anything at all. Then you may think after February 6th, who will give me food? Don't bother, I'll teach you begging also. In Nityananda, I equip you completely, not only by giving the truth, by after the truth, what all side effects will happen. I train you for that also. It's a complete course. The after the training, the job is also assured. And I do the placement everything. Just like placement guarantee. I do everything inside you. So don't worry about that. Are now unclutch, that's all. Some of us are planning to do Ananda Tapas after this. I told you, all your plans after February is a nonsense. First, unclutch from that. You seem to indicate that we enter either the Nityanandam or Ananda Tapas. Is Ananda Tapas just another marketing gimmick? Should we not doing it, or would it be icing on the cake? Or we should just do it. Now unclutch, okay? As we are mode of illogical, unconnected thoughts, again connecting it, see. Even the illogical, unconnected thoughts, they create a mode. Mode means what? Connecting that also. And having an umbrella. So nice. Nice, yeah. How will we manage to get trained in our professions? Are we not responsible people? Who told you you are trained in your profession? That has not become part of you, huh? That was only, that is only your skin. That is only your superficial layer. It has not become part of you. If it has become part of you, you don't need vacation. The moment you are becoming tired proves that your profession is not your part. You understand? Are you feeling bored or tired, exhausted at some point? Then be very clear, you are not trained professionally. How did you choose to come here to this course? That you only will know, I don't know. What is the difference between so-called normal people and mentally retarded? Are mentally retarded people unclutched? They are not unclutched actually. They are over-connected. See, in your case, you are connecting at some point, somehow you are able to manage to unclutch and rest. Those guys are not even able to manage that unclutching during sleep or during the boredom period. See, in your case, after a certain boredom or tiredness, you know how to unclutch and change and do something else. Those guys were not that intelligent and they were not able to do that. That's why they became mentally disturbed. That is the outer space of voice coming from. Somebody is saying, don't bother, that's a translation going on. Actually, there are few who don't know English, so the French translation is going on. Somebody is writing. There's outer space voice. I don't know what the word disturbance of voice coming from the lady's side. Translation going on simultaneously. If the mind can be aware of only one thought at a time, is it possible the mind is the one thinking it is body and mind? Then thinking it is enlightened. See, if you are thinking, then it is not enlightened. Is enlightenment product of the mind? No. And dies with the brain? No. Your mind is much sharper with great imagination. Oh, this is a nice question, challenging me. Now it's time. Let's. It's from the same person. I think from Dr. Ravi. Now I know. Understand? This is a very deep question. Sharp mind will not radiate compassion. The more your mind becomes sharp, you will see more you become logical. The more you become logical, you will be more violent. Logic means separating. It will never give deep fulfillment to you. One more thing. Staying with one body is impossible. Staying with one thought is impossible. Here is saying, if the mind can be aware of only one thought at a time, it can be aware of only one thought at a time, but that thought cannot be saved continuously. That's the first thing you need to understand. Any thought cannot be consistent or saved continuously. Second thing he is asking, the mind is the one thinking it is body and mind, then thinking it is enlightened. No. mind is the one which is thinking it is body and mind. When that dies, you don't think you are enlightened. You are enlightened. People ask me, are you enlightened? Let me be very honest. The moment I became enlightened, the idea, the doubt whether I am enlightened or not has disappeared. Same way the idea I am enlightened also disappeared. I neither have a doubt whether I am enlightened or not, nor I have an idea or clarity that I am enlightened. I neither have a doubt whether I am enlightened or not, nor have an idea that I am enlightened. Simply it is there, completely unclutched. Because all the masters use the word enlightenment to denote this state, to mention this state, I am also using that word. I am also using that word. Otherwise, that word has no meaning. Is enlightenment product of the mind? No. In a way, it is product of the mind because after it happens, after the mind disappears. So indirectly, it can be called as the product of the mind. Maybe enlightenment is side effect after mind's death. Enlightenment is a side effect of the mind's death. Is enlightenment product of the mind and dies with the brain? No. It is neither the product of the mind nor it dies with the brain. Your mind is much sharper with greater imaginations. No. Actually, I don't have imaginations. That's a big problem. I don't have imaginations. I can say only one thing. I appear to be very sharper because I know all the games which your mind can play. You may ask, how I know all the games your mind can play? Because my mind has played all those games with me. I managed it. Because I played with my mind, I can play with anybody's mind. The other day, after some program I came and told, there was a guy who was trying to play, who was trying to behave very intelligently with me. Then after everything I came and told, I told him that Ari was playing with the mind. I played with the mind itself. Understand? You are playing with your mind. I played with the mind already. So whatever your mind can play, I know because my mind played much more than that. Before death, your mind will do its final drama. It will open all its cards, or I can say, it will open everything. It will do its best. That's what it means when Buddha says that before enlightenment, Mara came, he tried to seduce me. Means what? All the things which is inside is coming out. If somebody has become enlightened, he has seen all the games of his mind, then naturally he can face all the games of your mind. So my mind, you can't say my mind is sharp or with great imagination. No. I don't have imagination. One more thing. Maybe you can feel my mind is sharp because I know all the sharp dramas played by your mind. Otherwise, my mind is not what you think as sharp. How have we managed to create disease in our bodies? All that is, does have nothing to do with our thoughts. It has something to do with your thoughts. How can we turn this around to help us? First thing, understand, every moment you are having new thought. Your body is created by your thoughts. Because you believe you have a consistent personality, you are connected, you have a connected shaft in you, you start creating the body also in the same way and do not allow rejuvenation process. Now understanding that you are unclutched, you will allow the rejuvenation process which is constantly happening in you to happen in a natural way. Unclutching is the best way to allow your body to heal itself. I have hard time with two personalities. After Nityanandam, I have third personality, which will be better. God, after already you started thinking about after Nityanandam. Who said you will go out with a third personality or any personality after Nityanandam? First thing, stop planning about after Nityanandam. Stop planning about, drop all your plans about after Nityanandam. What will happen to those two personalities? And there is, I have so many dustbins outside. Why don't you throw the two personalities there? Will they come back after 1 month? If so, how do I deal with it? Will it be better for my wife to do Nityanandam? So that she will be able to understand me better. I don't need to answer, you all have answered now. Understand? What you think as your personality, what you think as you, what you think as your ego, totality, it is nothing but the collected past. Am I right? Selected informations from collected past. Understand? Selected informations from collected past. It is not total past. Total past does not stay in your memory. It is only the selected informations which you want to select. You select them, connect them, and create the shaft. You understand what I am saying? For example, if you think your whole life is a suffering, you will collect all the thoughts which gives you suffering, connect them all, and create a shaft. Think your whole life is nothing but a suffering. Your whole life is nothing but pain. You have your own thought. You connect all of them and come to an idea about you. First thing, you thinking you are male or female itself is a shaft. Because many times you have been told you are female, you connect all those ideas and think, create a shaft, you are a female. Or you are a male. You create a shaft. With that shaft, you constantly try to work, try to be active. The big problem. The moment you create the shaft that you are a male or you are a female, you stop allowing many energies which are natural in your being. Not only that, any shaft will exclude something else. Any shaft you create, the other part will exclude. Whatever is excluded by you will take revenge on you. That's what is happening. Will take revenge on you. The suppressed part will take revenge on you. It will shower its vengeance on you. Why you choose particular set of thoughts and create a shaft also, no reason. Just for fun you start doing and your thoughts suddenly meet. That's the truth actually. When you started doing, you never thought it will end up in such a mess. And only after ending up in such a mess, you start thinking, "Arey, why did I start doing? Why did I start doing?" Now don't bother about all those things. Don't we have to pick and connect thoughts for any meaningful task? For example, to attend this course. To attend this course, till you attend this course, you need to pick and connect your thoughts. Now it is time to drop. Now, nothing more is your mind and body has done a big service to you by landing you up here. Now it is time to give them gratitude and send them, give them a good farewell. And you are asking. We had to connect many independent thoughts like booking ticket, registering next, for etc. etc. Registering for the course etc. Now you landed already here. Is it not? All right. One more. You say you can connect the thoughts. All the thoughts logically. Now I tell you, all right, connect all your thoughts logically and sit there. Let us see whether you are able to do it or not. Will you be able to connect all your thoughts logically and sit? That's what I am saying. Then why are you trying to do which you can't? See, Dilip is asking a question. I have to connect my thoughts logically. Only then I can do my work. I am telling you, all right. Please sit straight. Now connect all your thoughts logically and be there. How long will you be able to do? How long will you be able to do, Dilip? You can't. So you know you can't. That's what I am saying, then don't. Understand? See, if I tell you to be unclutched, you say I am not able to. If I tell you to be clutched, again you say you are not able to. Neither be unclutched nor be clutched. You are already unclutched. Understand? Neither you need to unclutch, because you don't need to unclutch. You are unclutched. Try to be clutched. You are not able to. Then just be. Look into yourself. Understand? Now I am talking an important truth. It's one of the important regulations. You will not be able to do any single act without contradicting thought happening in you. Anybody who says that I have done a single act without a contradicting thought happening in me, tell me. No. You can't. Not a single action is outcome of thought. Actually, we do not know what is the cause of action. That is truth. That's the truth. Always you will have contradicting thoughts. Why you execute this thought and you don't execute that thought? We don't know the reason. We don't know the reason. We don't have logical reason. That is what you executed. That's all you can say. Why you did not execute the contradicting thought and you executed that thought? We don't know. Understand? This understanding will create a deep clarity in you. A very deep clarity in you. You are suffering. You are torturing yourself by trying to find the reason for all your past actions. The main suffering, main cause for your suffering is you trying to find reason or justification for your actions. Your actions are not done with a logic. First understand that. Your actions are not done with a logic. You give the title or the name to that actions either as a good or bad based on the result which comes after the action. You don't have intelligence. You don't know. You have. There is nothing called intelligence. Let me be very clear. There is nothing called intelligence. You trying to find a reason for the whole is just a uselessness. Actually, there is no intelligence running this world. There is no intelligence. There is nothing. It is just accidents happening. From your birth to your death, everything is accident. Simple accidents happening. That's all. Simple accidents happen. Why? You also don't know, I also don't know. Nothing. That's all. And these shocks. Now these shocks.